Investigations and health checks continue as authorities track those who came into contact with Thailand's single case of the Chinese-born virus this week. Family members, residents in his home area, and those who attended discos where he worked, along with those who were in court or jail as he was processed on drug-related charges, have all been checked. So far, from the several hundred people, no one has failed testing. Many are now in quarantine, and the issue remains as to who did he catch it from. During investigations, it was revealed that one of the clubs where he worked not only had poor social distancing rules, but also sold a share a glass between friends promotion, which is beyond reality in the current environment. Yesterday saw reports of a single case of COVID again amongst new arrivals here, this time a man from India who was in quarantine. But the nation is on alert as cases in neighbouring Burma are escalating, seeing a spread there and concerned that it will reach the borders with Thailand soon. Military teams are monitoring the jungle areas where illegal crossings could otherwise be easy. With proper crossing areas blocked, the ease of crossing from other countries through rural and jungle areas is all too much of a concern for all. Garbled nonsense over the past few weeks has been put to bed this week as India, who proposed a tourism deal with Thailand, is now listed as the nation with the second highest COVID count globally. And China too has ruled out early reopening of tourism. Their embassy stated this week that the two countries are simply not ready, this according to The Nation News. Expats living here in Thailand are finding it hell to work overseas, as not only do they have to serve the 2 weeks enforced quarantine here on return, but in many cases have to do the same when arriving abroad, adding a total of a month of enforced lockdown to do perhaps 6 to 8 weeks' work. Heavy rains combined with a desire to get the ultimate selfie saw one Uzbekistani slip from the edge of a waterfall in Ranong province. Found dead at the scene, he's said by his pals to have ignored warning signs and clambered to the edge of a ravine just to take that picture before he slipped. Meanwhile at home and in Pattaya, one biker had a lucky escape when riding on the Sukhumvit. A poorly lit roadwork site caught him unaware, leaping from his bike just seconds before it plunged into a watery pit some 10 metres wide. Small roadworks around the city are often poorly marked and a real danger at night. This chap, well, he was lucky, but the sodden bike took some while to recover. When's a bargain not a bargain? Well, for one man, it's just when you can buy a used Honda Civic for just 55,000 baht. It seems he went to buy it from a private seller in the middle of Thailand, made it almost back to Sataheap before he smelt something burning. He stopped to get out to see what was what, only for the car to burst into flames, and told press that he plans to ask the seller for a refund. Now that will be an interesting conversation. And they're gone. The Bangkokians who arrived en masse for the 4-day weekend fled at the same rate yesterday, leaving the city to return to its new norm of tranquility and virtual silence. A cash cow and boost for some businesses. The catch, of course, is that the city may simply have seen a month's visitor count in just a few days, as most will not consider returning here until after their next payday. And it's back to work for all today, seeing government buildings reopen. Anyone behind on their utility bills or needing immigration services may want to wait until the end of the week, though, as queues are bound to be extremely long. For those determined, well, take sandwiches. And with the reminder, mitts, masks and meters, wash your hands, wear a mask and keep social distancing, and the Met Office promising highs today of 32, dropping down to 26, a good chance of rain and storms at any time. That is the local and national news from Fab FM. For videos and, of course, to keep up with fabulous Pattaya, visit alwayspattaya.com.